Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going to do a cheese ball. It's a cream cheese ball and I think you'll really enjoy it. It is probably my favorite and I get more compliments on this cheese ball than any of the others that I try. First we need 8 ounces of cream cheese. So one full box here of cream cheese. And it needs to be at room temperature. You will put it in a mixing bowl. It should be a shallow bowl, so I've chosen just a regular Pyrex pie plate. And the first thing to do is just mash that up because it is very soft, and that's because it being at room temperature. If you get it up right out of the refrigerator, you'll probably have trouble with this dip. But you want that completely mashed up, and you might have noticed that I have gotten the fat-free variety. You can use regular cream cheese and probably that would be a little bit better tasting, but I'll just give up a little bit of the taste there in order to save on fat and calories a little bit. Next thing I'm going to add is dried beef, and you can see this is Armour brand. It's 2.25 ounces, but I haven't used all of it. You can see in my dish where I've chopped it up, I have used these circles, but probably a little over half of it has been used, and I'll save the rest for later. And what I need to do is just use kitchen shears and do long slices and then cross slices, and you'll have these little squares. That will be our next ingredient. Added to that will be the tops of green onions. This is one bunch. And you can see I'm not using the entire bunch. I just washed them and dried them and started at the end, cut off the dead ends. And then I started with the kitchen shears and just snipped them, as you can see, into this dish until it was to my taste. If you like green onions a lot, then put more in. If you don't like them so much, then you might want to have less than that. So let's start mixing this up. I'm going to put the dried beef in with the mashed cream cheese. And then before we even blend that, we're going to put the onions, the green onions. And I just use the green part. If you like lots of onions or you're doubling the dip or something, you can go on up to use the white part as well. So this is what it's looking like so far. Get these out of your way. And we'll just mash this until it starts to come together. It does have a couple more ingredients, so I'm not going to completely prepare it, but I think we're ready to add those ingredients. So I'm going to move down here where I have Accent. Now you're just going to use 1 teaspoon, and I've measured it out here. Just sprinkle that over it, and I would try to sprinkle pretty evenly so the mixing won't be so necessary. And then I have 1 teaspoon of Worcestershire sauce. So that's going to go in next. I've measured it out. I just splash that in. Those are all the ingredients for the actual dip. So let me get this together. You'll see what it looks like, and then I'll show you how to serve it. This is a very simple dip to make. It's quick and it doesn't require a lot of ingredients. It's not tremendously expensive and it has loads of taste. You can see that it's almost finished, and it will be finished when the brown of the Worcestershire sauce gets blended in. And then you'll know that you're finished with the mixing. Sorry about stumbling over the words. I've said that 100 times, I know, but it still doesn't come easily off the tongue. All right, we're ready to serve this up. And I've just chosen a small dish. And I actually prefer to have this shaped. And to do that, you would have to refrigerate it, and then you could use a spreading knife or something of that nature. but we'll not take the time for that, and it's not necessary. Usually you'll have it sitting out and it will get to room temperature anyway, so it doesn't really matter what form it takes on. So this is my complete dip. And the way I'm going to serve it today is to place it in the center of a large flat plate. And then I like townhouse crackers with it. You can use the reduced fat townhouse crackers, or what I've chosen is just the regular for this. I think it tastes just a little better. Now notice the one on top here. I just opened this a while ago. It is broken, so I'm going to place that aside. The others, I'm just going to place around the dip, and then I will arrange them until we have a complete circle. I want that to look fairly nice. And when you get it arranged to your liking, then it's ready to serve. Let me take a bite, see how it turned out. Just make sure I get a little bit of chipped beef, a little bit of green onion, and enough of the binder to have a good taste of it. It's just like usual. It's great.